How are we, Game Leapers? Coach Eggs bringing you another video, and in this episode you will learn the most important tips for top lane matchups. We will be covering how to play against melee and ranged champions, and what your goals should be heading into the lane. Keystone knowledge, trading patterns, strong side versus weak side, playing fog, all of these and more will be talked about, so don't go anywhere because all of these tips are essential if you are to become the best top laner. Remember to help a video out and leave a like, we really appreciate it. Subscribe so you don't miss any of our daily uploads. Quick shout out to our website, GameLeap.com. If you're serious about unlocking your potential on League, then look no further. The market leader in providing you with informative videos, courses and guides, uploaded and updated on a daily basis, made by challenger players and coaches to help you reach your potential. Alright, let's get into it. Let's focus on what to do in melee versus melee matchups. The first thing I want you guys to think about is your keystone and theirs. This is the determining factor in how you go about dueling your opponent. The most common ones for top lane are Grass of the Undying and Conqueror. Both are different and require different playstyles. We want how we play to resonate with what we're playing and running. There has to be intention behind our rune setups, fam, and it helps us to envision how the lane will play out. For example, Grasp is all about short trading and is great in the early game. When auto-attacking an enemy champion with Grasp stacked, you steal some of their health and heal yourself in the process. It has a 4-second cooldown, so your goal is to duel the enemy champion with Grasp stacked and disengage. Rinse and repeat until you out-sustain the enemy top laner and force them to back. Grasp is ideal on champions like Gangplank and Shen. Conqueror, on the other hand, is all about long trading and scales incredibly well. For top laners that heavily rely on auto attacks, Conqueror is the optimal choice. As a melee champion, each auto attack and ability that hits an enemy champion grants 2 stacks. Each stack you gain bonus adaptive force, and at 12 stacks you heal off your damage dealt. Champions like Aurelia and Riven thrive when using Conqueror. All of a sudden, we know to a certain extent how to play against the enemy champion based on their keystone of choice. Next thing I want us to focus on is fighting for level 2. So level 2 is arguably the most important level up in League of Legends because your power essentially doubles in terms of cooldowns. There's 2 against 1. It doesn't matter how good or how bad the matchup is, you will always win a fight. It is very important to remember what minion and wave you hit level 2 off because you can catch your enemy unaware and potentially kill them. What minion do you hit level 2 off then? What's the second wave, first melee minion? If you got that, good job. If the enemy laner is matching you by auto attacking the wave themselves to try hit level 2, hit the first melee minion of the second wave to get to the power spike quicker. There is no point in hitting multiple melee minions because you are postponing your power, man. The third tip for those melee against melee matchups is trade patterns, and this is purely micro-based. In other words, what you're doing with your HUD keys and mouse clicks. It is essential if you are to become a better player to think about how the first 3 levels in level 6 play out in terms of fighting. Each level is different because new abilities add a new dynamic to the lane. At level 6, for example, ultimates are now leveled up, and the matchup may favor one champion over the other just because of one of these ability spikes. Some top laners like Gangplank and Shen have global ultimates that are best used to support their teammates. Of course, you can use your GP ultimate for yourself, but other ultimates like Malphite's Unstoppable Force, Fiora's Grand Challenge, and Darius's Noxian Guillotine are a lot more impactful in the 1v1. How do we go about using these abilities? Well, it depends on the champion you're playing and the matchup for sure, but there are 3 types of trade patterns. There's all-in, which is when you fight, you do so until one of you dies. You trade, which is when you fight, it's short and sweet based on your cooldowns. And you poke, you want to harass the enemy champion for free. All-in champions include Darius and Aurelia, especially if they land their CC. Champions that want short trades include Vladimir and Wukong. And champions that want to poke include Teemo and Quinn. Now, some of these champions can cross between trade and all-in or poke and trade, but understanding how a champion should efficiently trade will help you guys out immensely. Strong side versus weak side is our next tip, and this is one influence in knowing when to fight as a top laner. Do you guys think it's a good idea to fight if there is a strong possibility of more enemy champions being close to your lane? Or would you rather fight when you have teammates close to you? This is what defines strong side and weak side of the map. The strong side equals more players, the weak side equals less players. In the early game, playing the strong side of the map will most of the time mean your jungler is top side and the enemy jungler is boss side. As a result, you want to force fights with the enemy top laner so you can soften them up for a gank or dive. If the enemy team was to gain something on the other side of the map, like a kill, objective, or advantage in jungle camps, let's say, then you must create a winning situation on your side of the map, and being passive in lane is not the solution. Being passive in lane is the solution, however, when you are on the weaker side of the map. In other words, you want to avoid fighting until the map is neutralized or you have more members topside. If your team is able to win the bottom side of the map, you win the entire map by staying alive. For that mini situation, you dying is the compensation for the enemy team, so don't give them any opportunities. Don't give them any compensation. Play safe and respect the weak side. The last tip for the melee matchups is TP versus Ignite. In a straight up 1v1, which summoner spell is more useful? Ignite, obviously. So whoever is running Ignite should have the upper hand in duels, and it's commonly run in low elo. This effectively acts as another cooldown. How many of you have died to Ignite and you didn't even realize the enemy top laner had Ignite? I think most of us have. So at level 1, for example, instead of being one ability versus one ability, it's one against two. And thinking like this will result in you playing more efficiently. You will maximize those gains and minimize those losses. If both laners are running teleport, then nothing changes in terms of trading. What we envisioned before the game started remains true, and we stick to our plan. One of the most common questions I get asked is, what do I do into ranged champions as a melee? Well, just leave, I guess. Hey, I'm joking, of course. Most low elo players think that ranged champions never lose top lane. Well, they do. And if that was the case, then every high elo top laner would ban Quinn, Teemo, Vayne, and the like. So here are some key tips when playing into ranged champions. Respect the poke. Your goal for the lane is to hit your level 3 safely most of the time, because at level 3 you have 3 basic abilities and should be a lot safer in lane. So what does safer mean? This correlates to health. You do not want to take significant harass for CS. It's important to value your health way more than gold from the minions. You have to accept that the early stages are going to be rough, but they will become even harder if you get chunked for going for 14 gold, which is a melee minion. Give up farm and hit your levels so you can actually play the lane. Even if you hit level 3 or level 6, and these are generally your points of power, they mean nothing if you are under half HP after the first couple of waves. Do not cuck yourselves, game leapers, and respect the poke early on. Tip number 2, into ranged matchups, playing fog. One of the keys to making the lane more playable is using the brushes. Because the brushes conceal you, it means the enemy laner cannot harass you unless they have it warded. Great thing about top lane is that there are 3 brushes to utilize, so you have more chance of staying healthier in lane. They are also great ambush points. After shoving the wave, you can try bait the enemy top laner into face checking one of the brushes. This turns the melee versus range matchup into a melee versus melee matchup, and that's exactly what you want. Who here has questioned their ADC when they headbutt the enemy Ornn or Maokai? That's what we're doing here. So play the fog. Tip number 3 for playing against ranged champions is patience, and it relates to tip number 1, respecting the poke. Yes, we play League of Legends to have fun and test our limits to see what we are capable of, but we need to know when to test those limits. Doing it level 1 as a Garen into a Teemo isn't going to end well. We have to realize that ranged champions have chase potential. You may gap close to them as Garen, but eventually you are going to run out of cooldowns and health because the ranged champion can retaliate when you are running away. This often results from being impatient and trying to win the lane before it's even started. The higher you climb, the more these little details matter, and if you are going to climb, they matter right now. Wait for that power spike and away you go. Punishing enemy mistakes. Tip number 4. The pressure is on the ranged champion to win their lane. Ranged champions are a lot less forgiving than tanks and bruisers, so it's important to keep this in mind. One mistake on Vayne, one mistake on Vladimir, and the lane becomes infinitely harder. In lower levels of play, mistakes are commonplace, so there will be plenty of opportunities for you to engage and win the fight. The enemy might overextend or trade in your minion wave or take a tower shot, that's your green light. This carries on to tip number 5, and that's pinging your jungler to punish even more. Ranged champions will typically push into you, so the lane is always gankable for your jungler. Because you will have a lot of enemy minions in front of you, it's essential to time your engage with your jungler so you don't get chunked before the gank occurs. Now, yes, you can do this to bait the enemy top laner, but you might have to blow your flash in the process and can still die doing so. I would recommend playing it safe and making it a 2v1 for as long as possible. Remember these tips for both sets of matchups, guys, and you will improve your top lane game massively and climb as a result, I know it. If you enjoyed the video and learned something from it, leaving a like would be sick, as would subscribing to the channel because you legit do not want to miss any of our must-watch daily uploads. And if you're serious about becoming the best, you have to head over to our website gameleap.com, the only place for informative league content that will make sure you become the best player you can be. This has been Coach Eags. Until next time, peace.